We had a deal, wolves. You stay out of my side of the forest, and I stay away from yours. Not only did you break that, you attack a friend of mine. Hopefully, the next generation of wolves respect our deals more. To keep up appearances of being the evil, scary warlock of the forest. True, you are partly to blame. How many times have I told you not to venture in the woods alone at night when it's raining? Now, village chief, why are you here? And how many times do I have to tell you? Vice Village Chief doesn't roll off the tongue very well. You want to ask me something? Well, we'll go back to the cottage then. Unless you prefer talking in the cold rain. Dry and warm it is. Before that though, cue. Patrol the territory. I want to know if the commotion attracted anything or anyone unsavory. If you do, let me know immediately. Well, ladies first. Have a seat. Make yourself comfortable. How about a drink? Coffee? Tea? Potion of immortality? Yes, hot chocolate is far better. Besides, immortality is overrated. I would know. Oh, is it my turn to share more about my past life? Time really does fly. Immortality. It's once again tied to my adventuring days. I've fought countless enemies. Doing awful things. To attain it. And only three has achieved true immortality. All three of them, mind you, lost their minds a long time ago. And were only motivated to cause havoc. Here's your hot chocolate. You're welcome. Now, that adrenaline should be wearing off right about now. And you'll feel the pain of the cut on your leg. I would assume you got that cut from running away from the wolves. It's not that deep, but we should treat it. We don't want it to leave a scar. Now, I might only be using the Warlock title, since it's easier for the head village chief to accept help from me. Doesn't mean I don't know how to make and use potions. My official title. No, it's not this anymore, since that only applies to that kingdom I resided in, but I was referred to as the mortal god, which I admit might not convince the head village chief that I mean no harm. So a warlock works. It's an easier pill to swallow that I can do miraculous feats because I talk to a higher being. This is going to sting for a sec, but we're done. That should heal up in a few days. Good as new. And again, you're welcome, Vice Village Chief. Is it hard to fathom that a mage referred to as a mortal god would give up everything to live in a remote forest, helping a small village? I wanted to avoid going further. A mortal god. It's only a few steps away from immortality. Something I never want to be. But a lighter reason would be, is I want somewhat of a normal life. Adventuring was fun, but not for me, I like to think. I'm glad I ended up here too. I do have great company here. Right, before we get lost in talking about my past, you went here to ask me something. I gather it's very important that you couldn't wait till morning. Is one of the kids in the village sick again? Was someone cursed? Did someone spontaneously combust? There was a common occurrence back where I was. Can I make you a potion? Of course I can. It depends on what the potion is. But I did restock my ingredient supplies recently, so I... You want me to make you a love potion? I'm surprised. Never thought someone like you would ever need something like that. Do not mean to offend. It's just that I was sure you would have anyone fall for you easily without the use of magic or potions. Well, it is a request from a friend, and I owe you for being kind to me this past year. So, consider it then. I have the ingredients to make it, so you can make it now if you want. Wonderful. Oh, her and my kingdom. They refer to her as a helper golem, made from the mana in the air and whatever natural material around us. Perfect for fetching and helping me with ingredients. Isn't that right, Rim?
Rim, help.
You always do, Rim. I'll write the ingredients you need to get for me in the storage. Please be sure to wrap them in sea monster paper. I need them to be as pure as can be.
Rim on it.
And be careful of the diamond flask. It might be too heavy for you, so carry it only when you've brought the other ingredients here.
Rim understood.
Thank you, Rim. Now, to set up the cauldron base. Nymph tears. Not to worry. They give them to me willingly, so long as I help them out too. Kelpie mane to sterilize everything. And dash of great tree sap to protect all of it.
Rim has ingredients.
Thank you, Rim. Remember, be careful of the flask.
Rim, remember.
Now, while I mix all of this, I'll explain the rules of this potion. This little potion won't immediately make a person fall in love with you. Potions of that nature are volatile and, frankly, I just don't like them. However, what this potion does is relaxes the person's mind and feelings to be more clearer. So if they already have feelings for you, they'll notice it more. And it will only work if your feelings for this person is also real. It requires both of you to be aware of each other for it to work. Not the kind of love potion you hear from stories. Are you satisfied with this? I'm glad you are. This potion will work wonderfully for you then.
Rim back with flask.
Thank you, Rim. Just in time. Go sit over there. We deserve the rest.
Rim, thank you.
Dragon's dear. Very rare material. I got this from my adventuring days. It will bind all of the ingredients to work perfectly together. That is the only thing I can use to make this love potion work. I wouldn't worry too much. I'm sure dragons still cry if I ever need more. Is something wrong, village chief? What if it doesn't work? Do you love this person? You really do. You're worried they don't love you back, right? Not to speak out of line here, but I'm sure they love you back. You're wonderful, after all. Everyone in the village knows that. Even travelers quickly tend to fall for you. It's very easy to fall for someone with a beautiful heart. Isn't that right, Rim?
Rim, village chief is love.
We're only stating what is obvious. But it is normal to worry when it's about love. Now, for our last ingredient. A single strand of hair from a maiden truly in love. I'll be gentle with your hair, I promise. Of course, I'll answer your question. What is it? Hypothetically, can a mortal god fall for you? The exposure of true love, and the potion that will blossom it to its full potential. The potion is complete, and yes, even a mortal god would fall for you. You never know, one may already be in love with you. Q, what's wrong? Intruders, huh? I did make a lot of noise earlier. I know. We have a lot of things to talk about, but first, I need to deal with this. I'll be quick, I promise. Take care of Rim for me. She worries a lot.
Rim, stay safe.
How does it feel, knowing the person you love, loves you back, and he didn't even drink the potion yet? I'll be back. time to be an evil warlock again.